Here we are. We're back on the Sony Xperia 1 Mark V. Yeah, this mic placement's a little bit weird, but we're gonna run with it. So, we're using the vlog monitor at the moment to do this. So just go quick recording this so you can actually see it on the video. But yeah, this setup is just killer. I absolutely adore it. We're using Videography Pro, something that you couldn't use with the Xperia 1 Mark 6. And I can't tell you how happy I am to be back on this phone. The 21 by 9 screen, the display. Now, the display, even though the 1 Mark 6 display is really good, it's brighter, it's LTPO. But it doesn't feel as smooth. It doesn't feel as smooth. I don't know if it's just because this is like always on 120. I mean, you could enable that with the 1 Mark 6 as well if you really wanted to. But there's something about this screen just feels different in just the way it feels as well. I don't know what it is. I don't know what it is, but it feels nicer. And, you know, battery life isn't as good as it is on the 1 Mark 6, but honestly, not too fussed. Not too fussed. I've missed this phone. It feels like an Xperia. The 1 Mark 6, as good a phone it is, in many ways, it just didn't feel like an Xperia. It felt like other phones. That's going to be difficult for most to make sense of, especially if you've not tried both phones. But yeah, it's good to be back. And as I say, we've got this set up right now. We are recording S-Cinetone. This is 4K 30. We're using the DJI mic, vlog monitor, DJI mic 2, should I say. Yeah, it's just a really nice recording setup. And in terms of video features, you have more video features than you have on the 1 Mark 6. Obviously, we're supposed to get video features added back into the new camera app on the 1 Mark 6 soon when the Android 15 update comes along. We'll see. But I don't see how it can work. I don't see how it can work in the same way that this does. For me, this is the perfect setup. I think the app is just laid out really well. And this also applies to the Cinematography Pro app and the Photography Pro app. The Photography Pro is the one thing that bothered me the most from the 1 Mark 6 is that with that new interface, you feel like you're knocking things. It's very easy to catch something, change the settings, difficult to sort of just keep things locked in. And this just makes more sense to me. It's so nice to use. I just pray, Sony, please, 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 don't chase the normies. Stop it. Stop it now. Go back to the camera setup, the app setup on the 1 Mark V. There's already a basic mode. I don't understand even why you needed to do it. There's already a basic mode there. I just want the pro layout that we had. That's all I ask. That's all I ask. Give us that with a 1 Mark 7, please. Please, please, please. But yeah, and one thing I will say as well, performance-wise, I am not noticing a bit of difference from this to the 1 Mark 6. Because the 8 Gen 2 from Snapdragon was already an absolute peach. So I think unless you really, really want the macro photography side of things, you want the full resolution mode, which is kind of gimped in a way because you get the full 48 megapixel mode on the main camera. The other cameras are still 12 megapixels, so there's no full resolution mode there, and you can't even shoot in RAW with that full resolution mode. Full megapixel. I don't even know what I'm saying anymore. I've lost the plot. 48 megapixel full resolution mode for the main camera, there is no raw mode. That makes zero sense to me. And also with the macro, no raw. Make it make sense. Make it make sense. I have no idea. But there's a lot of things to correct for the Mark 7, and I think when they went in with the One Mark 6, they didn't really have much of an idea of what they were actually doing. I think they were just like, oh, we need to try and make everything, we need to try and make everything like a Samsung, because that's what Sony users want. But yeah, this is just a quick video. I just wanted to sort of say, back on the One Mark 5, we will do a review of this, but probably more so in the new year, I would think. So give myself a little bit more time to use it, and using it as a camera, using it for video. We're going to be using this as a B cam as well, so it's going to be interesting. It's going to be good. But thanks very much for popping in. I appreciate you. Stay grounded. I'll see you soon.